suited to the occasion, Mr. Sean P. O'Kelly is inaugurated President of Ireland. By the free vote of the people of his country, this great Irishman was elected to the highest position of honour that the nation can offer. The inauguration ceremony was but the fulfilment of the desire of the Irish people that Mr. O'Kelly should become first citizen of the state and the guardian of the Constitution. Church and state join in doing honour to the occasion. Solemn votive Mass of the Holy Ghost is celebrated in the Procathedral, Dublin. Here we see some of the distinguished congregation leave at the close of the church ceremony. His Eminence Cardinal MacRory, Archbishop of Armagh. The Apostolic Nuncio, Most Reverend Pascal Robinson. Most Reverend Dr. McQuaid, Archbishop of Dublin. The President-elect and Mrs. O'Kelly, the Taoiseach, the Taoiseach, and other members of the government. For the inauguration ceremony, the arrival of the President-elect is heralded by a fanfare of trumpets, and, accompanied by Mr. Lemess and Mr. McEntee, Mr. and Mrs. O'Kelly approach the dais, while those within the hall stand to attention. Mr. O'Kelly now reads the declaration in which he solemnly promises to maintain the Constitution and uphold its laws. The fanfare of trumpets acclaims his entry into office.
Thamshe Sean Thomas O'Kelly, Da Yanuant, Agar Da Yarafu, or Salamanta, Escopirino. The Im Haka, I was in Yidi, the One Rock Eire. I was at Leher, the Pervna.
He now receives the Great Seal from the Chief Justice, pauses, and signs the declaration which he has just read. On behalf of the government, Mr. De Valera congratulates the President. The President replies in a few short sentences. The assembly stands to attention and the ceremony is brought to a close. President and Mrs. O'Kelly lead the company from St. Patrick's Hall. Outside, he inspects the guard of honor and then drives through the streets of the capital on his way to Eire and Uachtaran, acclaimed by the thousands of our people who line the streets. At intervals of 15 seconds, a battery of 21 guns fires a salute throughout the presidential procession. Having arrived at Eire and Uachtaran, the cavalry officer seeks permission to withdraw the escort. Some good views of the party at close range. The President, the Taoiseach and Mrs. O'Kelly, the Taoiseach, members of the government and the Council of State. Acceding to the repeated spontaneous acclamations of hundreds of children, the President and the Taoiseach acknowledge their greetings. With him we pray that in his great task, God may give him the grace, strength, and courage to act in a manner worthy of the trust our people have placed in him. Follow ye, agus a wáthar